It's interesting. I mean, the EHR workflow itself in value-based care just needs to be better informed with the things you need to do proactively for the patient, right? And so from our standpoint, whether it's value or service, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, the provider is treating a patient, but needs to do that with full information about the patient, because otherwise they may not be making the right decisions, right? And so I'd argue that it's not as much in the EHR as much as the EHR needs to be better informed by the patient's full information, not just the information in the EHR. Because the reality is, as a provider, you need to understand what happened, not just within your own organization, but what's happened to that patient outside. On top of that, when you look at practice management and when you look at how you manage the patient from the beginning, you're going to do things proactively that you're not going to get paid for right away. So it's more on the back end business model that you really need to target the capabilities of the platform to make sure that you're comfortable providing proactive care for patients, because you know that's going to make your patient pool sustainably profitable for your organization. Interoperability has come a long way on a much longer journey. And so as we sit here today, we're starting to see seamless interaction and trading of data back and forth. But now the next step in that is, based on the fidelity of that information and what use cases can I truly support? And so that's really starting to come to the forefront. We've kind of got as we solve the first constraint, which is information trading, the next constraint is really information accuracy and actionability. And so I think that's going to be the next inning is, okay, great, you know, before I trust this information coming in from a foreign system, I probably want to double check it. And in fact, I may even want to do the test myself again, because I don't know if they did the test appropriately or correctly. And so interoperability is starting to generate value. We've still got a ways to go before it supports some of the more complex and critical use cases in the industry.